For an essence test, I don't know why we waived those rules, because she's just going to break them anyway. She's sort of the Eddie Murphy, George Carlin of the Barrister Bowl. Sheila's been a solo practitioner for over 19 years in Tulsa County and surrounding counties. Her current practice is devoted mainly to criminal law. She's a celebrated Tulsa artist who handcrafts custom jewelry, and she holds a registered patent on her own unique design. She received her undergraduate degree and her law degree, both from the University of Tulsa. Sheila, sponsored by Wood, Pool, and Wood. Sheila's going to be first in place or thing. Place. Place it is. Heaven on earth.
I know, I'm sponsored by Wood, Pull, and Wood, Scott Wood. Yeah. I love this firm. And I make a joke about it, but it's too obvious.
Sheila, what's your topic?
My topic. It's heaven on earth. Okay. Did you guys really waive the rules for me?
There are no rules.
I did not.
Fuck. That's awesome. That means I get to talk about the judges too. Yeah, three of them that I appear in front of all the time. Yeah, I love arguing in front of them. Of course, sometimes, you know, all the Tulsa County judges, of course, sometimes their mind will start to wander when I'm starting to talk, and I have to remind them, Judge, I'm up here. Seriously. But, no, I would think that heaven on earth would be, oh, I don't know, the Playboy Mansion. Yeah, I like that topic. I couldn't believe that threw it away. So it is heaven on earth, except for the one thing that's wrong with it is you got that old guy, Hugh Hefner, that's sleeping with all the hookers, or the ladies, okay? And I can't believe that. It's like, if I want to get screwed by an old, nasty, male chauvinist pig, I'm going to vote for a Republican. And the Playboy Mansion, they got new security. I mean, they needed it. I mean, the Secret Service. And, of course, it's the only job they could qualify for now. But at least now they're being patriotic. They're sleeping with American prostitutes. I mean, did you see how the Secret Service got in trouble for sleeping with the Colombian prostitutes? And all the politicians, who, by the way, were at the Playboy Mansion at the time, were shocked and dismayed that they didn't find the hookers first. So, I mean, one of the Secret Service guys took one of the Colombian prostitutes to Obama's room, and he was completely disgusted, of course. You know, he said at the very least it was in poor taste, because he ordered a Brazilian. Anyway, I don't know how much time I got left. I got any time left? Like I said, I am a criminal attorney, and I do the normal, everyday, run-of-the-mill, okie-type crimes like DUIs, making a meth lab, bestiality. Is it still bestiality if you just lay there and the animal does all the work? Anyway. I said fuck. Oh, butt plug. Yeah. I said it.
I just think you left out the Secret Service guy arguing about money with a hooker. What's your take on that?
Well, you know, I mean, they protect our sensitive information. I know there's a joke there. And he left his personal credit card. What the fuck? I know. You're right. Thank you guys very much.
Sheila.
Oh, wait.
You're not the hook yet. Is your name spelled right in the program, or is it spelled right on your gift basket?
Well, see, Sometimes I go by S, period. And on the gift that I'm receiving, my last name is misspelled Natch. Huh? Who did that?
You mentioned Brazilian earlier.
Oh, the Brazilian? Yeah. That's right. It kind of goes with that too. God, you guys are embarrassing me now. Yeah, thank you guys very much. So.